Donald Trump still seems to be laboring under the delusion that there's no such thing as bad press. According to a campaign memo that was revealed by CNN this week, the Trump campaign says that they want as much media attention as possible on Donald Trump's criminal trial. Here's what it says. Advisors told CNN there's an effort to begin, quote, blanketing the airwaves with Trump allies and potential vice presidential picks to defend the former president against the more than 30 felony counts he's facing. The Biden trial talking points, as it's called, tells allies to describe the trial as an assault on democracy and a witch hunt orchestrated by President Joe Biden. The document also reportedly stresses avoiding the term hush money in reference to the trial. It describes the case instead as an entries in the company's records situation. The talking points memo acknowledges that a conviction is possible, but stresses jail time is not. According to the document, Trump faces no realistic threat of jail, even with a wrongful guilty verdict from the jury. These are literal talking points put out by the Trump campaign to the people that they're going to be sending out there in the media to defend him. One such person, of course, is Alina Habba, and she's already done a horrific job of it, which is probably why the campaign has had to say, like, hey, we're going to have other people too. Like, it's not just going to be her. We're going to have people, and they're going to stick to these talking points. But now the jig is up, right? Now we know exactly what you're going to say. So I'm assuming, right? I would assume, now that the media knows about this, that they're going to be prepared to counter each and every one of these talking points, right? They're going to do their homework. They're going to actually have their team of researchers and producers work on counterpoints to all of these. No, they're not. They're going to do pathetic pushback, and they're going to let these people come on the airwaves and spread these lies. If I were CNN, if I were MSNBC or ABC or 60 Minutes or CBS or any of the other networks other than the conservative ones, I'd do a blackout. Total media blackout of any Trump ally. Do not let them on the air. You know what they're going to say. You know how they're going to spin it. There's no reason to talk to them. No reason at all. Let them go on Fox and Newsmax. Let them go on these conservative podcasts. Do not put them on the air because you now have the memo instructing them on how to lie about what's happening. If you put them on the air from this point forward after knowing what their plan is, you are engaging in journalistic malpractice. But aside from that, Trump wants to blanket the airwaves. He wants all the media networks covering this. And that is the dumbest thing ever. Every single poll on this issue shows that if Trump gets convicted, he will lose in 2024. A majority of voters believe that Trump has broken the law. A majority of voters do not want the trial to take place after the election. A majority of voters are in favor of what happened, and a majority of people believe that he did the things. So putting more media coverage on this is not going to help win anybody over to the Trump camp. Furthermore, it actually has the potential to turn off a lot of people. Because let's not forget what this is about. This is not just about hush money. It's about why the hush money was paid. Because Donald Trump had an affair. He had an affair as his wife was home with their four-month-old baby Baron. He had another affair with Karen McDougal, the Playboy playmate. Like, his infidelity is the key here. And once we actually get into the meat of the trial, you know, beyond this week's jury selection and whatnot, that's going to be the talking point, and that is going to kill him. So he wants media attention. And to that, I have to say, be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.